Hello, in this video we will learn about intracellular signaling. Let's get started. In the video on cell-to-cell communication, we have seen that cells in our body communicate by sending chemical messengers. When a cell releases a chemical, it is equivalent to speaking. The other cell listens with receptors. The listening will be fruitful only when the target cell responds. Now, in most cases, proteins for ultimate response are far away from the receptors. So, there is a system to pass the message from receptors to the target proteins. This system is the intracellular signaling or second messenger system. Hey, if it is a second messenger system, what is the first messenger, you say? I'm glad you asked. The first messenger is the extracellular signal molecule that brought the message from the other cell. So, now as you know what is second messenger system, let's learn something more about it. The intracellular part of signaling starts with the binding of the ligand with the receptor. We have already seen a separate video that various types of receptors are ligand-gated ion channels, G protein coupled receptors, catalytic receptors, and nuclear receptors. Now, downstream to these messengers are multiple second messengers. One messenger passes the message to the other messenger. This transfer of message occurs in form of activation or inactivation of downstream messenger. For example, GS protein activates adenylyl cyclase, which in turn increases the concentration of CAMP. CAMP then activates protein kinase A. Thus, there is a cascade of events. Finally, the signal goes to the target protein that initiates the ultimate response. A target protein can be a transport protein that alters the ion transport across the cell membrane, a metabolic enzyme that alters metabolic reactions occurring in the cell, gene regulatory protein that alters gene expression, a cytoskeletal protein that alters the shape or movement of the cell, or cell cycle protein that alters growth and division of the cell. So, this is the basic thing that happens during the intracellular signaling. Transfer of signal from receptor to the target protein. Please remember that this is a general theme. Exact receptor, second messengers, and target proteins varies in different cells. But this is not the only function of the second messenger system. As the signal is being transferred, other important things also happen. These are amplification and integration of signals. Let's see both of these functions in a bit more detail. First, amplification. See, one upstream molecule can activate or generate multiple downstream messengers. For example, this messenger can activate 100 downstream messengers, and they in turn can activate thousands of downstream messengers. Thus, the signal is amplified as it travels towards the target protein. The second function is the integration of signals. The second messenger system allows to converge or diverge the signals from the first messenger. Different ligand receptor combinations may activate the same intracellular signaling pathway and thereby affect the same response. For example, epinephrine and glucagon are obviously different first messengers and they activate different receptors. But after that, they both follow the same second messenger system, that is the cyclic AMP pathway. So, they both produce the same response, that is an increase in triacylglycerol breakdown. Thus, different messengers can affect the same function. On the other hand, second messenger system also allows diversifying responses from the same first messenger. The same first messenger may activate a different intracellular signaling pathway in different cells and produce different responses. For example, acetylcholine follows CAMP pathway in heart muscle cells and decreases contractility. But in pancreatic ACNR cells, it activates IP3-DAG pathway and induces secretion of digestive juice. Thus, the same messenger can produce a different response in different cells. So, this was all about intracellular signaling or second messenger system. Let's have a quick summary. The second messenger system conveys signals from receptors to the target proteins. It occurs by series of activation or inactivation of different second messenger molecules. Some examples of second messenger molecules are CAMP, IP3, DAG, CGMP, etc. Target proteins can be transport proteins, metabolic enzymes, gene regulatory proteins, cytoskeletal proteins, or cell cycle proteins. These target proteins initiate the ultimate response by the cell. The signals are amplified as they travel deeper. Apart from this, second messenger system integrates signals. Different ligand receptor combination may activate the same intracellular signaling pathway and thereby affect the same function. And the same ligand may activate a different intracellular signaling pathway in different cells and produce a different response. That's it for this video. If you feel this video will help your friends and colleagues, please share it with them too. And don't forget to subscribe because lots more to come. At Nonstop Neuron, learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.